This gets goddamn tougher every night.
Still got it,
bro. I will tell you this. I am so proud of what we did in wrestling in ECW. Because we told an Irish jackass in Stanton, Connecticut, where he can shove his sports entertainment, that we wrestling fans wanted the sport of professional wrestling. No goddamn cartoon. Is no cartoon. Dominic DiNucci is no cartoon. Superstar Billy Graham was no cartoon. Hell, a guy in a skirt named Rowdy Roddy Piper was no goddamn cartoon. $1 billion named Dixie Carter invite herself into our sport. And we wrestling fans told her what she could do with her $500 million. You hear me, Dixie? Let me turn it up for you. If you'll allow me a few more minutes, if Brett slipped or something, and two of those brothers are no longer here. Every night I get a chance, I love to introduce them. But you guys remember them, because they were no cartoons. From Asbury Park, weighing 473¾ pounds. He was the best big man in the history of this sport. Ladies and gentlemen, upstairs tonight, I give you a beast from the east, Mr. Bam Bam Bigelow. And the anchor of the triple threat, weighing 223¼ pounds, from Spring Lake, New Jersey. Ladies and gentlemen, no gimmicks needed, Prince. Mr. Prince Candido. When we raised those three fingers, which we can no longer do, we changed wrestling forever. But I see the dressing room back there tonight. And in shows like this across this country, that there are snot-nosed idiots like Troy Mark that wanted to be professional wrestlers. Not cartoons, Vince. Not highly paid bimbos, Dixie. Professional wrestlers. If you fans are on board with this, I'd say it's time we start a revolution. Take back our sport from the Irish jackasses and from the wealthy bimbos. And tell them professional wrestling has nothing to do with that. It resides in places like Woodbury Heights, New Jersey.